Hi, I'm Rong Zhu with Keysight Technologies. In today's video, I'm going to introduce you how to do successful power amplifier digital pre-distortion measurement by using PathWave test signal analysis software called X-apps. Here's the agenda. At first, I will introduce you the new DPD approach called Iterative Learning Control DPD. After that, I will introduce you the Keysight Solutions for this part. At last, I will give you a live demo of measuring PA performance with Iterative Learning Control DPD by using 5G NR signal. Now, let's get started with the first part. As we discussed in the last video, power amplifier is a nonlinear device. When signal goes through the power amplifier, the gain cannot be sustained, especially in the higher power region. As we can see that in upright area in the graph, the line goes down compared to the straight line. This is called as gain compression, as the nonlinear range significantly distorts the signal and the related out-of-band emissions. Signal processing algorithm aims to minimize these distortions. So, a digital pre-distortion modeling is added before the power amplifier to distort the signal in exactly the opposite way as the DUT power amplifier does. So, in an ideal world, the DUT power amplifier distorts the pre-distorted signal so that the output signal is linear again. We've talked about typical DPD models in the last video, such as memoryless model lookup table, and a memory model like memory polynomial and Vortora series. If you are not familiar with this part, please go to the link in the description box. DPD modeling is an algorithm that takes any input signal and pre-distort it. Usually, an FPGA or ASIC applies the algorithm in real time to a signal. However, algorithms are limited by their complexity. Complexity limitations also apply for non-memory models, but are the dominant factor when it comes to the memory models. So, in the memory models, the pre-distortion of a given waveform not only depends on the current state, but also on the previous states. So, the complexity will grow exponentially with the amount of memory taken into account. So, a key question during amplifier design is the maximum performance of a device assuming the perfect DPD. Keysight provides you a new DPD approach called Iterative Learning Control DPD that allows the measurement of a device performance by pre-distorting a given waveform on a sample-by-sample basis instead of developing the DPD algorithm. This approach allows comparative measurements across devices and saves the amplifier designers from having to sort out the influences of different DPD algorithms. So what's more, Iterative Learning Control DPD allows the modeling of any memory effect without increasing the complexity, since we know that any pre-distorted value P at time and T depends only on the measured sample, so where the memory effect of the device is present in the measured samples. So in our approach to pre-distort each individual sample so that the output signal comes as close to the original signal as possible, it is obvious that a single execution of this step is not sufficient, especially when the power amplifier shows significant memory effect or significant nonlinear behavior. So in order to pre-distort all significant memory effects, our sample-based approach works iteratively. Next, let's look at Keysight solutions for measuring PA performance with ILC DPD. ILC DPD method is available in X-app power amplifier measurement with license number called N9055EM0E. Here's an example of 5G signal which has significant SPR and EVM improvement with iterative learning control DPD applied in nonlinear region. So meanwhile, you can get 5G NR and WLAN demote EVM results in the power amplifier measurement. X-apps share same measurement size and expertise across multiple hardware platforms. This new approach for the DPD is ported from modular PXIe instruments to the benchtop spectrum analyzers, covering from high-end performance benchmarks, economy to low-cost purpose, making you get the consistent measurement results across the product whole lifecycle. Next, I will show you a live demo about how to measure power amplifier performance with Iterative Learning Control DPD. The instruments I use here is VXG-C signal generator and UXA analyzer. Here are features you will learn in this demo. Let's get started with hardware connections. To do power amplifier measurement with Iterative Learning Control DPD, you need to prepare a signal analyzer and a signal generator. Here I use the VXG-C for the signal generation and the UXA for the signal analysis. The DUT power amplifier with attenuator is connected between the RF output of the VXG-C and RF input of the UXA. VXG-C has two channels here. The channel I used here is channel 2. In the rear panel, you need to connect reference ports, trigger ports, and LAN ports between the VXG-C and the UXA as listed here. After hardware connection start, you need to prepare the reference signal waveform. You can use PathWave signal generation desktop or embedded software version with N7631APPC license to generate 5G signal. Or you could prepare your own waveform. To see how to generate 5G NR signal by using PathWave signal generation desktop, please go to the link I put in the description box. I'd like to mention one more thing that if you want to get 5G NR demode EVM results during the power amplifier measurement, you need to have the 5G NR mode analysis measurement application license as well. Now, we are ready to download the reference waveform to the VSG. In X-app, click on the tab of the main tab to open up this mode measurement view selector screen. Select power amplifier mode, power amplifier measurement, then press OK. In the power amplifier measurement, go to the signal generator tab, set the send frequency to 3.35 GHz. Click on connection management. In this connection management page, the connected signal generator will be detected and listed here. If the connected signal generator is not detected, you can add it by tapping its IP address. After that, press connect button. The detailed information of the signal generator will be extracted and displayed in the information box once it is connected successfully. Next, remember to modify VXG-C's channel source to channel 2. As we know, VXG-C has two channels, and we are using channel 2 now. Next, go to the reference signal tab, press select waveform, select the reference waveform we prepared before. After that, the reference waveform is downloaded to the VXG-C. After source configuration, we are now configure analyzer's part, set the SA send frequency to 3.35 GHz. Next, go to the measurement standard tab to configure the radio standard as we used for the 5G NR. Now we can enable IF output of the signal generator to playback the reference waveform. Next, let's go to the amplify tab to set the amplify parameters, such as the gain, loss in, loss out, and input power. From AM and the AM-PM graph, we can see that the power amplifier is now in the linear region. Let's go to the 5G NR mode analysis measurement to check its demode EVM. In 5G NR measurement, set the send frequency at 3.35 GHz. Next, go to the mass setup, select the mass standard tab, select downlink test model 1.1, and press apply preset button. All demode parameters will be automatically set for you. Next, let's go to the mass set time. Change search time in the subframe length to the one subframe, same as the length of the reference waveform we used. After that, we can see that the waveform has been demodulated correctly. Next, let's see how to enable 5G NR demode EVM results in the power amplifier measurement. Now, let's switch to the power amplifier measurement. Go to the PA mass tab. Click on the EVM to open up EVM settings page. Select radio format as 5G NR and turn on EVM. Press preset from 5G NR EVM button, or demodulation settings will be coupled. Now you can make the same EVM measurement as 5G NR mode does inside the PA mode. Next, we will see how to measure power amplifier with Iterative Learning Control DPD when it works in nonlinear region. Now go to the Amplify tab, increase input power to -2 dBm from AM-AM and AM-PM graph. It is in the nonlinear region. Now we have a little bit worse ACP with increased noise level in adjacent channel, and the EVM get worse. Now we are ready to enable DPD. Switch to DPD tab. Before measuring PA performance with DPD, please modify the measurement mode from continuous to the single mode. Now we can select DPD algorithm as Iterative Learning Control DPD. Let's keep the iteration default value as 6 and modify the gain expansion to 0 dB. restarts the measurement to get PA without DPD at first. Then you can get the pre-DPD results in yellow color. Next, enable DPD and enable mass DPD iteration. After that, press Restart DPD iteration button. The measurement of PA with Iterative Learning Control DPD automatically starts, and the message shows that pre-distorted waveform is downloaded to the signal generator and play after each iteration. After a few seconds, you will get DPD, ACP, and EVM results of the iterations. From AM-AM and AM-PM graph, we can see that PA with Iterative Learning Control DPD is in linear region now, and in the DPD iteration matrix table, we can see that EVM has been improved, but ACPR have no improvement. Why does it happen? This is due to that DPD only take effect on the active bandwidth, not in the adjacent channels. So in order to solve this problem, we need to generate the waveform by oversampling to cover third order distortion bandwidth. Next, let's see how to do oversampling in the power amplifier measurement. First, let's disable DPD method. Go to the reference signal tab, press waveform processing, disable auto resampling ratio, and modify resample ratio to 3. After that, we can see sample points triples now. Restart the measurement to get pre-DPD results with oversampled reference waveform. After that, go to DPD tab to enable DPD method and restart DPD iteration measurement. After a few seconds, we can see that ACP and EVM are both improved now. In ACP graph, it is flatter in upper and lower band, and ACP decreased a lot than before. The ACP in upper band is minus 52.57 dBc after 6 iterations, which is nearly 14 dBc improvement. Next, let's talk about IQ averaging when measure power amplifier with Iterative Learning Control DPD. You can configure IQ averaging in Settings tab, or you can go to DPD tab and open up Iterative Learning Control DPD configuration page. You can modify its averaging number or disable it. Now let's disable it to see how this could affect the power amplifier performance. Disable DPD method and restart the measurement at first to get pre-DPD results. After that, go to DPD tab to enable DPD method and restart DPD iteration measurement. After a few seconds, we can see that ACP and EVM are both improved compared to pre-DPD results, but not as good as before when IQ averaging is enabled. This is due to the fact that Iterative Learning Control DPD compares a measured signal to an ideal one. Noise will make up for a significant portion of the difference. Every active part in the measurement setup has extra noise, including the power amplifier as well as the measurement instruments. All noise contributions add up and reduce the signal-to-noise ratio in the measured signal. So, Iterative Learning Control DPD requires a method to minimize the influence of noise or to separate noise and nonlinearity influences. So, X-app provides you IQ averaging here to minimize the influence of noise, which help you to measure perfect PA performance with Iterative Learning Control DPD applied. Next, let's see how gain expansion could affect your power amplifier performance during the Iterative Learning Control DPD measurement. First, disable DPD method, then press DPD algorithm configuration, enable IQ averaging as what we talked about before, then modify the gain expansion from 0 dB to 2 dB. After that, restart the measurement to get pre-DPD results. After that, go to DPD tab to enable DPD method and restart the DPD iteration measurement. After a few seconds, we can see that ACP and EVM have further improvements. In AM-AM graph, we can see with increase of gain expansion, Iterative Learning Control DPD approach linearize the power amplifier as long as possible than before. Next, let's see how X-app can extract an approximated DPD model from Iterative Learning Control DPD measurement for the DPD algorithm developer to evaluate the performance of his own algorithm. So you can go to the Iterative Learning Control DPD configuration page, enable Extract DPD Model, and select Model Type and Config Memory Order. After finishing Iterative Learning Control DPD measurement, you can press Save button, select DPD results, accept for Save PA model, pre-distorted waveform, and DPD model here. So after saving the DPD results, you can find your PA model file, DPD model file, and pre-distorted waveform file under your specified location. So in summary, from the demo, we know that three key points to make successful power amplifier iterative learning control DPD measurement. First, power amplifier nonlinearity causes impairments such as gain compression or third order distortion, especially when power gets higher. So the impairments directly impact to the key performance metrics such as EVM or SPR. So as we previously saw, third order distortion appears in the adjacent channels. So if we want to improve SPR, the pre-distorted waveform bandwidth also needs to cover adjacent channels. Oversampling the reference waveform can cover the distortion bandwidth. Second, remember to enable IQ averaging to minimize the influence of the noise. Last but not least, due to the maximum output power given by the power amplifier, a linear result is not possible. So increase gain expansion to modify the ratio of peak power of pre-distorted waveform to the reference waveform could linearize the power amplifier as long as possible. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thanks for watching.